One's Andrea Miller. Today is June 6th. I'm going to be performing a cranial nerve 1 through 12 exam. First up, cranial nerve 1. I'm going to have you occlude one nostril and take a deep breath for me. Occlude the other, deep breath. Can you smell through both of them?
Yes.
Good. Please close your eyes. I'm going to have you identify a substance. Occlude one nostril and take a breath. Good. Other nostril. What did you smell?
Happy.
Was it the same intensity on both sides?
Yes.
Good. Next, cranial nerve 2. I'm going to be doing a fundoscopic exam. Looking for abnormalities such as glaucoma, AV nicking, and hard exudates. Look straight out in front of you, please. Looking for the red light reflex first. That's good. And good. Next, for cranial nerve 2 as well, I'm going to be doing a peripheral exam. Please look straight in front of you, nod at my hands, and cover one eye, but do not put pressure on it. I'm going to have you identify numbers 1, 2, or 5.
1, 5, 5,
good.
1, 5, 5.
Other eye, please.
1.
Cranial nerve 2 and 3, the direct and consensual light test. Please look straight out in front of you. I'm going to be looking for constriction on direct simulation, and then look at the other eye for constriction on indirect. They should both constrict with direct and consensual light. If one eye doesn't respond to either direct or consensual, that would be a cranial nerve 2 sensory lesion. If one eye responds to direct but not to consensual, that would be a motor lesion on cranial nerve 3. Next is the swinging light test, also for 2 and 3, looking for equal constriction as I swing light between the eyes. If there is unequal constriction, that would indicate a Marcus Gunn pupil. Next, I'm looking for ptosis, blepharospasms. That's also cranial nerve 3. Okay, there's no ptosis, and close your eyes, and there's no shaking of the eyelids. Next is accommodation and convergence. I'm going to have you look at my finger. Fall in and out. Looking for steady eye movement. Good. And now for accommodation, I'm going to find the point of central gaze. Now look at my finger and at the wall in front of you. My finger, the wall in front of you. My finger, the wall in front of you. Looking for a lens thickening on that as well. Next up is H and X in space, testing cranial nerves 3, 4, and 6. Please follow my finger, but keep your head in a still position. We're going to be moving each direction 3 times, testing all the muscles, and pausing for a couple seconds at the end of each position. I'm starting with the H in space. I'm also going to end range. To make sure they keep their head still for this. Now with X in space. Good job. Next up is cranial nerve 5. I'm going to be using a pendulum for this. May I have your arm? I'm going to be doing that on your face. Is that okay?
Yep.
Awesome. Please close your eyes. Feel that?
Yep.
That?
Yep.
Is it the same intensity throughout?
Yep.
Same side to side?
Yep.
Feel
yep.
that?
Yep.
That?
Yep.
Same throughout?
Yep.
Same intensity side to side?
Yep.
Feel
yes.
that?
Yep.
Feel that?
Yes.
Same intensity throughout?
Yep.
Same side to side?
Yep.
Good. Feel that?
Yes.
That?
Yes.
Same intensity throughout?
Yes.
Same side to side?
Yep.
Feel that?
Yep.
That?
Yep.
Same intensity throughout?
Yes.
Same side to side?
Yes.
Feel that?
Yes.
Feel that?
Yes.
Same intensity throughout?
Yes.
same intensity side to side.
Good.
Now I'm going to test for his jaw strength. Please open your jaw against my resistance. Good. And I'm also testing for muscles. Please bite down. Assessing for similar size, bite down again, on both sides. Now I'm going to be looking for cranial nerve 7. Please raise your eyebrows up and then tightly close your eyes. Puff your cheeks up, please. And hold. Good. Now please smile for me. And a wide that you can cross the road. Good. Looking for that limbic smile. Next up, I'm going to be doing a test for hearing. Please close your eyes. Can you hear this?
Yes.
Good. Tell me when you can't anymore.
Yep.
Other side. Can you hear that?
Yep.
Tell me when you can't anymore. Looking for it to be about the same distance on both sides. This is all for cranial nerve 8. Next, the Weber test. We know if you can hear this and if it's different on either side. Is it the same on both sides?
No.
Which side is louder?
Louder.
Okay. I'm going to be doing the Rene test to see if it is sensory neural or conduction. I know you can't hear it anymore. Can you still hear it?
Yep.
Okay. If it was neurosensory loss, it would have the same air to bone ratio and normal ratio. If it was conduction loss, it would have an abnormal air to bone ratio. Now I'm going to have him doing tandem gait. If you could please stand over here, making sure he is barefoot. Please keep your eyes open and walk heel to toe towards me. Looking for any swaying. Good. Okay, please go back. He's swaying slightly to this direction. Now, please close your eyes. I'll be here to catch you and walk heel to toe towards me. Okay, good job. I'm going to sit back down. Now, I'm going to set to the side and look for resting nystagmus. And his eyes are holding still. Now, I'm going to be looking at his tongue for any atrophy or fasciculations. Please open your mouth and just relax your tongue in your mouth. Good. Now, please stick your tongue out. Looking for any deviation side to side. If it did lateralize, it'd be to the side of the lesion. Okay, you can relax. Now please poke your tongue into my fingers. Good. Testing for equal strength on both sides. Now we're going to be looking at his palate. Please open your mouth and say ah. Good. We're looking for elevation and also looking to see if the uvula deviates. If it did deviate, it'd deviate to the opposite side of the lesion. Now I'm going to be doing a gag reflex. This is for 9 and 10. Okay, please open your mouth. I'm going to stick this in the back of your throat. Good. Okay. Good. He did have a reflex, he just wasn't audible with it. Okay, and last but not least, for cranial nerve 11, please raise your shoulders up and resist me pushing down. That's for the traps, and try to rotate into my hand. Good. For SEM. And that is the end of my cranial nerve 1 through 12 exam.